Hello students, looking at current affairs for 23rd April, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these six. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, confirmed cases cross 20,000, nearly 4,000 people recover. So India has reported 50 new COVID-19 deaths and recovery of 3,959 patients, taking the recovery rate in the country to 19.36%, means out of all patients who have suffered from COVID-19, 19.36% have recovered. Earlier, this percentage was 17%. So now number of recovered patients have increased. The death toll in the country stands at 652. Maharashtra has the most number of cases. And central government has also announced that it would be conducting a telephonic survey where citizens will be contacted on their mobile phone from a number 1921 through the National Informatics Center. So this would be a survey to get an idea about the COVID-19 cases in the country, and more information can be put forth in the public domain. So here you can see how COVID-19 cases have progressed in the country. So in 67 days, number of cases reached 5,000. Then they doubled in 6 days. And further, you can see from 10,000 to 20,000 to 5 plus 3, 8 days. And this is progression of deaths. So 50 deaths. We had 50 deaths on, say, day 0. So in 10 days, we had 250 deaths. Then 450. And in 6 days, you can see it reached 650 deaths. Then next is attack on health workers to attract up to 7 years in prison. So Union Cabinet has approved promulgation of an ordinance to amend Epidemic Disease Act of 1897. So this ordinance is amending this act, making acts of violence against medical staff a cognizable and non-bailable offense. And it offers to provide compensation for injury to healthcare personnel or for damage or loss of property too. So this ordinance says that in case of attack on healthcare workers, investigation will be completed within 30 days and final decision arrived at within 1 year. And punishment will be 3 months to 5 years in prison and a fine of rupees 50,000 to 2 lakh. And in case of grievous injuries, punishment would be 6 months to 7 years in prison and fine of rupees 1 lakh to 5 lakh. So this is the change made in the Epidemic Diseases Act. The next is Indian test kits must for reliability. So it is said for a reliable antibody testing kit, India has to make its own. So this is what independent epidemiologists and biotechnologists in the country say. So reliable antibody testing kits are required. We had seen yesterday how ICMR has called back antibody testing kits and has said that their use should be halted, and there will be a study done by ICMR labs on its effectiveness, and then if they are faulty, manufacturers will be asked to replace them. And here it is said that these testing kits are very important. They are like home-based pregnancy test kits. So these antibody tests, they give results quickly. They only need a pinprick's worth of blood and they'll give the results. The result which they show is whether antibodies are present. So they can only detect antibodies produced by the immune system in response to the virus. And the antibodies can be produced between 7 to 14 days of the disease being infected. So this test, as it is said, is just for getting an understanding of how many people are suffering. But then confirmation of COVID-19 can take place only through PCR technology test, that is polymerase chain reaction, reverse transcription, PCR test. We have done reverse transcription, polymerase chain reaction tests. So those are the confirmatory tests, because they specifically identify SARS-CoV-2 virus based on genes. So whether the presence of virus is there or not will be through this test only. The antibody test also can detect antibodies linked to other viruses. So that is also possible, because specific proteins related to COVID-19 have not been specifically detected. So you can see. So it only tells you whether a person has ever been infected by the virus. That is what the antibody test does. Antibodies, because they can be produced not necessarily specifically to SARS-CoV-2, could even be generated by a variety of other pathogens. So there are four other common coronaviruses and antibodies that could be generated. And so far, it is said nobody has found a protein that is specific to SARS-CoV-2. So antibodies are also proteins. So that is which are generated by the body. Also, it is not clear that how tests validated by National Institute of Virology began to show widely discordant results for them to be paused by ICMR. So this is also a question raised by experts that these testing kits had been distributed in the across the country, given to states based on their validation by NIV, National Institute of Virology, Pune. And now why is it being stated that they have discordant, widely discordant results? So doubts are being raised here too. And if the testing kits are required because they have been imported, these testing kits can be manufactured by India too. There are at least 7 Indian manufacturers, it said, of these antibody kits who are awaiting approval from National Institute of Virology. And if they approve, then they can produce at least 1 million kits by end of May. The next is Trump signs immigration order. So President Donald Trump has signed an order partially blocking immigration to the US in a move he argues would protect workers from the economic fallout of COVID-19 pandemic. So blocking immigration, which has been his core agenda, and presidential elections in USA are due in November. So this is a strategy which has been adopted now by US President Trump. He would be stopping the issue of green cards. So these green cards are permanent residency permits. So issuing of green cards will be halted for 60 days. But then there will be exemptions to certain categories like temporary workers, such as seasonal farm laborers, etc. And President Trump says that this action would help put unemployed Americans first in the line of jobs as America reopens after the lockdown. So the order, initially it is for 60 days, but it is said that President Trump said that it could be renewed for the same period or longer. And second immigration focused order would also come forth, which is under consideration by Trump administration. Also, Supreme Court in USA has in recent months offered several significant victories to Trump administration on immigration. Like in March 2020, Supreme Court allowed the federal government to maintain a policy that will send more than 60,000 asylum seekers back to Mexico. Immigrants to be sent back. So that is there. But then also it is a case that presently, due to the lockdown, immigrants are not coming in. The economies have halted. So how is this going to specifically protect American jobs when no movement is taking place, because nobody is moving in out of countries presently? Then next is military satellite launched, claims Iran. So Iran has said that it has put its first military satellite into orbit on 22nd April 2020. The satellite has been named Noor, meaning light in Persian. And it has been launched from Markazi Desert in Iran, Iran's central plateau. The satellite is at a height of 425 kilometers above sea level from the Earth, and it is orbiting the Earth. And Iran says that this its first military satellite put in orbit makes it an emerging world power now. So that's what Iran is claiming to be. And the rocket which launched the satellite has the name Qassad, means messenger. So this is said to be the first time Iran has used such a type of launcher and has launched a military satellite. And the last news is Facebook buys 43,574 crore stake in Jio platforms. So Mark Zuckerberg's Facebook Inc. has announced that it has agreed to buy 9.9% stake in Mukesh Ambani's Jio Platforms Limited. So this will be for 43,574 crore rupees. So around 10% stake for 43,574 crore means the entire subsidiary Jio Platforms Limited of RIL, Reliance Industries Limited, is valued at 4.62 lakh crores. And this transaction will need regulatory approval too. And it is said this will help Jio platform to leverage Facebook's WhatsApp in accelerating business on the JioMart platform and connect neighborhood grocery stores with consumers. Also, Jio platform, it is said, will be using this money from which it will acquire from Facebook to shed its loans because it has a debt of 40,000 crores. So that is good. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. These news are also uploaded on the website, and also monthly compilation will be uploaded once the April month is over. There has been less news due to COVID-19. So other related news are not there. Majorly it is COVID-19 related news. So a compilation would be much more efficient than daily coverage of the numbers and figures. So you can refer that. Thank you.